we're all creatures of habit, you know, and so quite often we'll go to the same restaurants, we'll order the same bottle of wine and have the same couple of dishes. But because we keep ordering the same things, there's never that wow factor. I think because I've got that freedom to do what I want with ingredients and use ingredients that maybe you wouldn't ever order, it makes you say wow, and it gives you that experience. You know, it makes you want to come back again and say, well, okay, so this is what there was in January. What's going to be in March? Because March is very, very different. The amount of customers I meet that have not tried pineapple weed, and that grows everywhere, and it tastes like pineapples, and it's brilliant. You know, why fly ingredients in from thousands of miles away when we have flavours here that either are the same or we haven't explored? So we started off as pop-ups, and that was great, but you know, every chef wants a restaurant. We do 16 covers only. So I want it to be special when you come in. You know, I always found if you go to a big restaurant, people come in and go and all that kind of stuff, and it takes away from your experience. So the moment you walk in, it's your night. It's like going to a concert, you know, you all see the same band play the same songs at the same time. You all eat the same dishes at the same time. It's brilliant, and you get the menu at the end of the night, so I've got the freedom to give you what I want. So we did a dish not long ago, and it's bone marrow ice cream. Now, we do demos a lot, and you can see it's like a Mexican wave of the crowd going, oh, no. And, you know, so I served this for a few months, and it was the one dish that people always raved about. And then you tell them what it was, and it was like, wow, that was bone marrow ice cream, that's brilliant. But I couldn't serve that if people knew what they were going to eat, because that the initial thoughts of, that sounds disgusting, would get in the way of them enjoying it. So this idea of having a blind menu where people have no idea, it's very liberating, because it gives me freedom to give people things that taste great and not things that they want to eat, which are quite often very different things. I've got a nice marbled piece of ribeye. We're going to do a very simple, nice, very hot pan, sear it nicely, lots of butter, and then I'm going to serve that with a burnt cream. Very simple dish, two elements, but I want the dish to speak of the flavour of the beef. I don't want it to be the sauce that goes with it and the vegetable accompaniment. I want it to be about the beef. While it'll look like there's not a lot on my plate, I can get away with it because I do a tasting menu. But by diluting the flavour with all these other things, it's a lack of respect. You know, if I eat a piece of beef, I want it to be beef. I want it to taste the beef and nothing else, because that's the beauty, isn't it? That's the magic. So to make the dish, two pans, very, 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 very hot. In one pan, you put the steak. I like to cut my steaks in butter because, well, butter's flavour, isn't it? A lot of chefs will talk about putting your steak down and not moving it. I come from a different way of thinking, where I'll keep moving. Every sort of 20 seconds, I'll move my steak to a hotter part of the pan, so it gets a really deep crust. In the other pan, I'm going to put some double cream, and I'm going to let it burn. I'm not going to touch it, I'm going to let it burn till it reduces by about half. Take it off the heat, sort of mix it up a little bit, you know, sort of deglaze the pan of all that burnt stuff on the bottom of the pan, and that's your dish. Really, really, really straightforward. Personally, I love a ribeye because it's got lots of fat in it, and you know, it's the old cliche, fat is flavour and whatnot. I don't really use a fillet of beef because it doesn't taste of much. I'm not a big fan of sirloins and whatnot. I like a ribeye. But the most important step essentially is, you know, good quality beef. You buy a rubbish piece of beef, it's not going to taste of anything. You buy a really good piece of beef that's been aged for a long time, it's got that depth of flavour, you know, it's, you know, all the moisture's come out of it, so it's really intensely flavoured. And that's what you need, you know, you want your beef to taste of beef. It sounds like a ridiculous thing to say, but quite often we'll buy beef that's not been aged very long, and it's not from a great, you know, it's not from a great farm or a great animal, and it tastes of nothing. It's just the texture of protein in our mouth, and that's not good enough. For me, it's incredibly important that, you know, we represent where we are. You'd never ask an Italian chef why he cooked Italian food, would you? So why ask a British chef why he cooks British ingredients? This is what we've got.